this murder. The address is CBS.
Perfect.
Come on, Lupo.
Ta-da.
Oh my God, I can't believe I just did that. I am so clumsy. I swear, I wasn't even trying to walk and talk at the same time.
So few pretzels got broken.
Well, I just hope you didn't inherit my two left feet.
Yeah.
This is incredible. Olives, grape leaves.
Right?
Where'd you get all this exotic stuff?
Well, I have my ways. Now you eat. You're a growing boy.
Yeah, a growing boy who only had 4 hours of sleep the other night and a cold piece of pizza. This is good.
I'm sorry we had to cancel our dinner plans the other night.
That's
I was really
okay.
Looking forward to that.
That's all right. Long hours in the editing room. I understand that, remember? That's why I made you manager of the studio.
Mm-hmm. Well, it might be more of the same tonight. With Margot's trial coming to a head, we have to double up on the coverage.
Then you should eat right now. Eat. Just eat, eat, eat.
What do you got there?
How do you feel about going on a very, very far away vacation?
How far? Safari.
The photo kind, not the gun kind. They have this great, great tour guides. And after you have your safari, you go back to these little tents and they serve you these gourmet meals.
Interesting.
And then I think on the way back, we're going to have to stop at a Greek Isle, sit out in one of those white patios and watch the Mediterranean.
Ah, the grape leaves.
Yes, see?
But what about the kids?
Love the kids. I love the kids, but this is not for them. This is for us. I think we need to spend some more time together. Just the two of us. Especially after the year that we've had. And all this talk about the safari, I thought, you know, maybe after the safari we could put on our little white linens and act out our favorite scene from Out of Africa.
Which scene?
You remember that scene when they come back from staring down that lion and Meryl Streep is in her tent and Robert Redford comes in and pours water through her hair?
Just like this?
What do you say we find a different venue to meet next time? Courthouses? Lawyers? They give me the hives.
Hives? But why don't you buy some calamine lotion with the $100,000 barabons I gave you? I've been in there testifying for Margot so she doesn't go to jail for your dead business associate, Alec.
So, how'd it go?
Lousy. Next subject. Anything on Vicky?
Vicky.
Oh, great. Lois Lane.
All right, what's this about finding leads on Vicky? You think she's still alive?
Yep.
How'd you find out?
Isaac introduced me to a business associate of Alex who turned out to be Vicky's bodyguard.
The same associate who just happened to do a swan dive off the roof?
He fell off the roof, okay? And before he did, he made it very clear that I would never know what happened to Vicky.
And this leads you to believe that Vicky is still alive.
Yeah, we're using Isaac's contacts, and Lucinda's giving me carte blanche at the City Times as far as resources. I mean, FBI, FAA.
Well, I'll help you in any way that I can.
Can I have a word with you, Julia, dear, please?
How does she do that? Does she just, like, vaporize? It's scary.
You scooped him, and you're not helping him now. So stop this nonsense immediately.
What do you remember, Margot?
Nothing, that's all.
No further questions? You're doing good. We're almost done, hang in there.
Detective Hughes.
Listen. Thank you.
remember.
Remember what, Miss Hughes?
That sound. That sound the night that Alec was murdered.
Miss Hughes. Miss Hughes, what sound do you remember?
Well, that's the trouble. I don't know what's causing it.
Miss Hughes, is there something you'd like to share with the court about the night Alec Wallace was murdered?
I don't really know what it is.
Let's move on then. You testified that you were not in love with Alec Wallace. Okay, would it be fair to say that at some point there was a definite shift in loyalties on your part toward the deceased?
Yes.
And did this shift in loyalties jeopardize your job?
I suppose so, yes.
You suppose so? You were suspended from the force because of this shift in loyalties, were you not?
Yes.
And would it be fair to say that these feelings were so strong they caused you and your husband to become estranged?
Yes.
We were living apart before she even met Wallace. Why doesn't she explain?
Wasn't your husband and other members of your family, weren't they furious with you when you told them that you wanted to jet off on this overseas vacation with Alec Wallace and leave your children behind?
What's wrong with her? I don't know.
Miss Hughes, yes or no? Miss Hughes.
Yes.
So in other words, you were a desperate woman who had lost everything, her husband, her job, her family, all in romantic pursuit of Alec Wallace. Yes or no, Miss Hughes?
Yes.
And given those circumstances, didn't you need to believe Alec Wallace was innocent? Didn't you need to believe that Alec Wallace was in love with you?
Objection!
Yes, yes.
She's burying herself.
Order!
Your Honor, counsel requests permission to approach.
Approach.
When we asked some denture wearers why they don't use an adhesive, they didn't have a lot to say.
Don't need it.
My dentures fit fine.
No problems here.
But after we gave them Fixident, they just couldn't say enough.
It's amazing, the difference.
It's a great new feeling of security.
Comfort.
Confidence.
I just plain forget I have them.
That's because Fixident adjusts to the unique contours of your dentures and gums, forming a thin, powerful seal for a better hold than you ever thought possible.
I could just kick myself for not doing this sooner.
Find out for yourself what it feels like to Fixident and forget it.
This holiday season, when you buy an action-packed RC car at Radio Shack, you get a free official Stuart Little yo-yo from the Stuart Little movie, only in theaters. For RC excitement and the only place to get the official Stuart Little yo-yo, get in, get out, get what you want. Radio Shack.
In this life, there's just no stopping. No break for a hacking cough. No rest for a raw, sore throat. Aches, fever. But when you're desperate for relief, there is Theraflu. Fast, powerful, hot liquid therapy. With the first sip of that soothing hot liquid, you feel relief is on the way. Soon your throat is soothed, your cough calmed. Maximum strength Theraflu. Now in new honey lemon chest congestion and cough. Instant comfort, powerful relief.
Ah, the holidays.
The joy.
The love.
Not the Brussels sprouts.
With Campbell's Cream of Mushroom this holiday, give your family something really special. Green Bean Bake. Want to enjoy a delicious holiday tradition? We have a soup for that. Campbell's Cream of Mushroom.
I was one hurting cowboy.
Heartburn hotter than a blown engine. And pain? The antacid I took didn't do the whole job. And Pepsi takes so long. Then I tried Alka-Seltzer. Man, if it didn't work, a whole lot better.
Alka-Seltzer, the only one with the medicines to relieve all your symptoms.
Boy, it works fast.
And only Alka-Seltzer has the effervescent power to speed relief.
Alka-Seltzer. Made a believer out of me.
Get better relief. Get Alka-Seltzer.
Your Honor, my client is obviously not well. She's distracted and not focusing on the questions.
Or maybe you just don't like her answers.
Jessica, you know her, and this is not Margot. I'm just asking for a short recess so I can check and make sure that she's all right.
So you can coach her. Your Honor, I'm sorry. I object. This is obviously a play on the part of the defense.
Mrs. Hughes, are you feeling ill? You need a doctor?
No.
Do you understand the questions that are being posed to you?
Yet, I could use a minute.
Mr. Hughes, this is not a football match. There'll be no last-minute timeouts.
Miss Hughes, how did you feel when you learned that Mr. Wallace was leaving Oakdale without you?
I was concerned because Eddie was going with him, and I was afraid for Eddie.
So you're claiming at this point that you were no longer in love, I'm sorry, I mean attracted to Alec Wallace?
No, I had seen him in Tom's hospital room at his bedside, ready to pull the plug. I knew then that he had tried to drown Tom.
And how did you feel?
I told you before, I hated him.
You hated him? Of course you hated him. After trying to trick him, you end up falling for him yourself. And you end up the one betrayed and used.
Yes.
And this made you want to get him?
Yes.
Miss Hughes, in all your years on the force, have you ever killed anyone?
Yes.
How many people have you killed, Miss Hughes?
Two.
Now listen very carefully. Does the number of people you've killed include Alec Wallace?
No. I mean, I don't know.
All right, so much better to talk here in Jake's office rather than at the courthouse in front of the man himself.
Wow, such discretion.
Okay, I'm gonna give it to you straight. Let's have some straight talk here. We know, both of us, that Vicki MacKinnon is not going to be found alive. So, you supporting him in this quest, however kindly it was motivated, this is just gonna keep the man mired in his dangerous denial for a long period of time. So I just suggest to you, respectfully, politely, that you leave the man alone.
Can I just point out a little contradiction? I'm not supposed to help Jake find Vicki, but you and the City Times are making it a number one priority to help him. What is that? It's a power thing? You want a monopoly on his gratitude?
My reason is very simple. The sooner the search is exhausted, the sooner he comes back to his real life.
Real life being his work at the City Times.
Exactly. And the future, which he'll be able to look at in the sober, cold light of morning day, whatever the future may hold for him. And I'm sorry, darling. I mean, I shouldn't be the one that has to tell you this, but in case you haven't noticed, he isn't interested in you.
Interested in me?
Please don't make me spell it out. Back off. He doesn't need you.
I'll just put this stuff in the kitchen, and we'll sort out the bathroom stuff later, okay? Oh, what great flowers!
If I had my own place, I'd always have flowers.
Did you get these for our lunch?
No, actually, I've never seen those before in my life.
Really?
Oh, then who are they from?
I don't know.
Ooh, a secret admirer?
Oh, sorry, I can be a little nosy.
No, it's okay, just I'm sure they're just from a friend, that's all.
Well, that's a nice friend.
Yeah. Abigail, look, My personal life is a little complicated right now.
Mm. Well, not mine. I know exactly how I feel about the guy in my life. I mean, I just met him, but I feel like I know everything about
him. That is so great, sweetie.
Well, everything that matters, well, is important, you know?
You're about to see a toothbrush do something rather unusual. Introducing the Colgate Navigator. It bends wide open, so its bristles gently adjust to your teeth for a thorough clean. The new Colgate Navigator. Bent on cleaning better.
Do you want your parties to be really special? Try Rocher, the European speciality your guests will adore. Smooth chocolate, crunchy hazelnut, a luxurious taste sensation. It's more of a party with Rocher.
Look at this uniform. It's dirty. It stains.
It's perfect.
What?
For dry Ultra Clorox 2.
Who?
Me. I get rid of tough stains and make colors bright.
Even these stains?
Dry Ultra Clorox 2. It does what Clorox bleach does on whites, but it's buffered to do it safely on colors.
So bold and bright. It's perfect.
Another home run.
Easy now.
Dry Ultra Clorox 2 Color Safe Bleach. The Clorox bleach for colors.
There are 7 million kids in this country who wet the bed, often because their bladders haven't grown as quickly as the rest of their bodies. One product can help, that protects, yet looks and feels like real underwear. It's helping a lot of kids feel better about themselves. Good nights mean good mornings.
If you're one of the 36 million people who wear dentures, this is big. New 5-Minute Polident cleans stains, then forms an invisible PolyShield barrier so you feel fresh all day. 5-Minute Polident with PolyShield.
The Craftsman 14.4-volt cordless drill and flashlight kit is only $99.99 at Sears. Perfect for every little job around the house. Give the good life. Sears.
This week, The Late Show's all new with Gwyneth Paltrow, Danny DeVito, Alanis Morissette, and Jim Carrey. Tonight, don't miss Courtney Love and R.E.M.
That's why I'm so glad you're going to meet him at Lillian Holden's.
Why don't you give me a hand with this stuff, sweetie?
Because I know that once you do, you're going to feel the same way. And then we won't be breaking any rules. And you won't have to worry about my mom sending for me from Saudi Arabia. Because, you know, he's great. He's super good looking, but so much more than that, you know? We like the same books, we laugh at the same jokes. Have you ever met somebody that just gets you, you know? Like you've been waiting for each other forever? Oh, and he's got the most perfect
name. You know what, Abigail? I was just thinking, you know, let's go out to eat instead.
Well, what's wrong with here? I just need you to okay the copy for this afternoon's broadcast.
This couldn't wait?
Not if we want to use those segments for the early edition.
Okay, I'll be right with you. Sorry about this. She's been working overtime. She's been working so hard, trying to keep her mind off Margo's trial.
Look, I would be doing the same thing if I were her. You know, Katie, Margo has a lot of people who support her out there, and they're not going anywhere.
Thank you for saying that. I needed to hear it. I just feel so totally helpless. I mean, there's nothing I can do to help her.
You love her. That means more than you'll ever know.
Yeah.
Just try to keep busy. It's all you can do. Speaking of which, I have to pick up the kids. So I will talk to you later.
Okay, I'll talk to you later.
Enjoy your work.
Katie, come on over here. What I want to do is move this story on the school board elections ahead of this one right here, okay?
Which one?
This one right here.
Miss Hughes, you claim to have been drugged on the night Alec Wallace was murdered. And yet, according to this medical report, no evidence of drugs was found in your system. Is that correct?
Margo.
Yes.
You also claim that you planted a listening device in the victim's apartment, but yet no device was found there.
Listen.
I'm listening, yes.
You also claim that you went to the victim's suite to gather evidence, but yet your fingerprints were the only fingerprints found on the weapon that killed him.
Listen.
Miss Hughes, can you hear me?
Yes, I'm listening.
Wouldn't you say it was rather convenient for you to lose your memory at this point in time?
Very.
I don't know what you mean.
You don't know what I mean? It's a very simple question. Do you think it was convenient for you to lose your memory at this point in time? Yes or no?
Buried.
What?
Well, let me put things this way. If you were still a cop, and you were faced with the evidence presented in this courtroom, what would you do? Miss Hughes. If you were still a cop, would you arrest the woman sitting before us? I repeat, would Detective Margot Hughes arrest the woman sitting in this courtroom?
Answer the question, Mrs. Hughes.
Are you listening?
Yes.
Nothing further, Your Honor.
Your Honor, permission to approach the bench.
You may approach.
It is obvious that the defendant is under emotional distress.
This is obviously a ploy by the defense to waste the court's time.
It will be a waste of time if you lose this on appeal.
Does the defense have any more witnesses to present?
No.
Redirect is postponed until tomorrow before closing arguments. This court will resume session tomorrow, 9 a.m.
All right.
Go. What the hell is wrong with you?
Are you implying that I am trying to help Jake find his wife because I'm trying to put the moves on him?
If the shoe fits.
Oh, my God. You are... All right, listen, Lucinda. Jake is not my type, first of all. And on top of that, he's grieving for his wife.
My dear, you have abandoned common sense many a time before, and you certainly do have a knack, admit it, to getting yourself marooned with the man over and over again.
But that is because he happens to be showing me the ropes on what has turned out to be an incredibly dangerous story, which he will not back down from, and that has gotten us into some jams. Lucinda, the man is my mentor. I mean, he doesn't think of me that way.
It wasn't his thoughts that I was questioning.
Do you want to open the window?
Why?
Just to cool down that overheated imagination of yours. Now, listen, this is none of your business, first of all. But ever since the whole debacle with Reed Hamilton, I'm detoxing from men. Now, maybe you have another agenda here.
Would you like to tell me what it is?
Well, maybe you have designs on Jake yourself. Maybe you have a fixation on your protege, Lucinda.
Social anxiety disorder is an intense, persistent fear and avoidance of social situations. Over 10 million suffer. Do you? Does an unreasonable fear of embarrassment cause you to avoid most social interaction? Is your anxiety around people so intense it can feel like a panic attack? Has this overwhelming anxiety significantly impaired your work or social life? Now Paxil, the only medication proven effective for social anxiety disorder, offers new hope. Paxil can help you overcome your anxiety so that in time, with your doctor's help, you may move toward recovery. Paxil is not for everyone. Tell your doctor what medicines you're taking. People taking MAO inhibitors shouldn't take Paxil. Side effects may include decreased appetite, dry mouth, sweating, nausea, constipation, sexual side effects in men and women, yawn, tremor, or sleepiness. Will you ask your doctor for more information about Paxil? Do it today. Your life is waiting.
Just because other cleaners are blue like Windex doesn't mean they can clean glass like Windex. Windex with ammonia D leaves a beautiful streak-free shine just about anyone can appreciate. Windex, best on glass.
this holiday season, give him the first triple blade razor. Mach 3 from Gillette.
Look what Conair can do for hair. Take you from curly to straight hair easily with straight styles. Steamy Mist gives you extra straightening power, leaving your hair looking healthy, silky, and shiny. Get straight styles from Conair.
Your turn to pick a name for gifts, Terry. You are going to Radio Shack.
Right around the corner.
For cool gifts like personal two-way radios, come to Radio Shack.
Well,
let me see those. Howie.
Welcome to Walnut, a town that shows what America will look like in the 21st century. A rainbow of races living and working together.
What happens if there's no real majority, if we're all minorities?
Take a tour with Ed Bradley to see a future that may already be here. Countdown to 2000 tonight on the CBS Evening News with Dan Rather.
A lawyer is caught between the battling parents of a boy with AIDS.
How can you possibly expect me to know what's right?
All new Family Law, CBS tonight.
Susan Sarandon stops by tomorrow on The Early Show with Brian Gumbel and Jane Clayson.
I'm not going to dignify that with a reply. My concern is to shield my editor-in-chief from any further unpleasantness.
Is it possible, Lucinda, that I am standing in front of a very, very possessive woman?
You seem to know all the possibilities. You know, you should really try to break the habit of picking the wrong kind of guy that you can't count on. Like Jack. And then Dr. Hamilton, I'd suggest you should see a psychiatrist, except that didn't work out so well last time. And now with Jake, you're running after him, stealing from him, because it's easier than developing your own stories. I mean, I would have thought you had some standards and that you could come up with something original.
Stealing? I am not stealing. Jake and I are working on this story together, and you know that, Lucinda.
Excuse me, y'all want to tell me what the hell's going on here?
Well, I sure hope the jury wakes up with amnesia tomorrow, because that's our only chance of winning.
Hey, what's going on?
It's that tapping noise.
The one that's been driving you crazy that you can't seem to place?
Yeah, it was there in the room the night that Alec died. It was there. It was Jessica's feet when she was walking by here. It kept coming back to me. It was a sound just like that in the room right after Alec was shot, and I couldn't focus on what Jessica was saying because all I kept seeing was Alec's body.
You saw the killer?
I'm so close to remembering now. I know that I was drugged and I know that I was almost unconscious, but that sound was in the room, and that's why Alec's ghost came here today.
Oh boy.
Margaret's been having visions of Alec since the murder. We think it's her memory coming back.
Hey, why not?
Okay, did you see anyone else in this memory? I mean, a shadow, anything?
No, just Alec.
All right, then listen, you got to buy us time because her memory's coming back.
Would that be a day, a week, or a month? Because I don't think Judge Blanchard is too keen on stall tactics.
Fine, you can't buy time. We'll speed things up. Come on, you're coming with me.
What, where are we going?
We're going back to Alec's suite. We're going to take you back to the scene of the crime, and we're going to do a little sensory recall. We're going to jog your memory and put an end to this thing once and for all.
Abigail, sweetie, it's not that I don't want you here. It's just that, well, actually, I'm not feeling too good. And so the thought of cooking tacos I'm just thinking we'll just go out for a light bite and then you can tell me all about this new guy, okay?
Are you mad because I want you to meet him even though you don't think I should be seeing boys? I mean, you're so young that sometimes I forget you're my mother.
No, that's not it.
Well, because I thought if I got Holden's permission, then I wouldn't get in trouble with my parents.
That's not it at all. Ow!
Mom!
Are you okay? You know, it's my stomach.
I can get something from the medicine.
No!
Do you want to do this another time?
Yeah, I'm sorry, but that would be a really good idea.
Sure.
Oh, Abigail, you know what? Next time, we'll stop by the station first, and we'll raid the music library. They come out with all the CDs before they're released.
Great.
I promise, okay? Here, let me give you here's some money for the bus, okay? Get back to Holden.
Okay, bye, Molly. I hope you feel better.
Thank you.
by Abigail. You be careful, okay? Hughes, get your butt out here now!
That was your daughter?
I'll be right back with your new low Geico rate. Great. I can save you over $250.
Every week, 10,000 drivers switch their car insurance to Geico. We take all the necessary precautions. Geico Direct. A 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Busy day.
What?
You want everything to be perfect. And it all goes by so fast. Before I knew it, it was 2 in the morning. The one thing I didn't obsess about was my skin. I always use this body wash from Dove. Like 200 hugs later, my skin was still so soft.
Now, Dove All Day Moisturizing Body Wash has 3 moisturizers that hydrate, replenish, and smooth your skin, keeping you softer longer than the leading body wash.
I just wish my feet could have lasted as long.
There's a very small window in the life of baby vegetables when they're extra sweet, extra tender. And at Bird's Eye, that's exactly when we pick them. Bird's Eye baby vegetables. Bring a little
wow
to your table.
This holiday season, when you buy an action-packed RC car at Radio Shack, you get a free official Stuart Little yo-yo from the Stuart Little movie, only in theaters. For RC excitement and the only place to get the official Stuart Little yo-yo, get in, get out, get what you want. Radio Shack.
The Braun Oral-B 3D, designed to pulsate deep between teeth. It pulsates to loosen plaque and oscillates to sweep it away. It cleans better than an ordinary toothbrush. The Braun Oral-B 3D, it pulsates deep to clean better.
A moment of forbidden passion.
Nobody has to know anything.
Could last forever.
You did turn off the camera, right?
Now she's desperate to keep their secret.
It's a videotape. I need to find it right away.
But it may be too late.
My, my. So that's how they kept warm.
Guiding light.
What happens next is everything.
It's everything. Ray Romano bringing you TV's greatest moments on TV's greatest entertainment show.
Then an Ally McBeal exclusive. And
Sailor.
Matt Damon singing on E.T.
tonight at 7.
Diamonds, the gift that lasts forever. The jewelry exchange in Tustin imports all their diamonds direct. They carry thousands of diamonds, most GIA or EGL certified, and all the guaranteed lowest prices. 1 carat solitaire start at $5.99. The jewelry exchange makes all their jewelry in their state-of-the-art factory and has hundreds of rings, pendants, earrings, and bracelets. Only the jewelry exchange in Tustin guarantees all their jewelry to appraise for at least double, that's right, double the purchase price. Buy factory direct and save. The jewelry exchange in Tustin.
Part of my life. Now's a great time to make it a part of yours. Call 1-800-204-2400.
Please make a gift donation to the CBS2 Giving Tree and Toy Drive.
For Judging Amy, the address is CBS.
Yes. That is my daughter. Why do you have a problem with that?
Because she's so big. I mean, in comparison to the picture when she was just a little baby.
Yes, okay, I'm old enough.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean
yeah, you know, you wrecked my whole afternoon plans with my daughter. Do you know that? And wasn't it you who said something about not invading each other's space? Hello, Mr. Breaking and Entering. What's up? Why are you here?
I just wanted to bring you flowers. I mean, to apologize, that's it, I swear. Because You know, when we saw each other the other day, the mood was a little bit chilly. And when I came up, the door was open, so I figured it would be okay to bring the flowers
Not
inside.
Not okay, all right? My life is a little too complicated right now to play these kind of games. Okay, I'm guilty too, but we both need to stop it now.
No, I agree completely.
Oh, great. Well, we finally understand each other then. Perfect. And we take this secret to the grave with us. You understand?
That's a deal, Molly. I'll see you around.
No, you won't.
You're right. I won't.
Well, I guess being the son of one of the owners does count for something. Hey, come on. Just take your time. You know, walk around. Relax. Just let it. Let it come to you.
But what? What? I know the tapping is something, but what? I don't know. And why does Ella keep saying something about buried?
Look, this is going to be unpleasant. I want you to lay down right where you were when you passed
no,
out.
We no, have
to.
Tom.
It's the only way. We have to reenact what you remembered in court. You can do this. Just, I'll be Alec. Just tell me where to stand. Come on. You can do this.
Here.
Here?
And then, fall toward me on the bed.
Like here? What? No, it's okay. It's okay. You all right?
It's just too close. It's too close. Don't. Everything I fear. That maybe I did do it. Maybe Alex
Come
slipped
on,
me the
Margo.
Roofies and then I thought that I was in some sort of physical danger. And so I shot him from here. And I could have done that because I knew the gun was in the briefcase right there.
That's perfect. It's perfect. It's exactly what we want. A clear-cut case of self-defense.
It doesn't explain the tapping.
All right. You're right. Is that it? Sound like that?
No. It's clanking.
Okay, come on. Just sit down.
Oh.
Just sit down. How about this? Anything like that? Here? Over here? Something
no.
like that?
But keep going. What have we got to lose? Keep going.
So, did Isaac tell you anything about Vicky?
Yes, but he wants to check up on him. Himself. I wouldn't wish this kind of waiting on my worst enemy. So, what are you doing to my friend here?
We were just chatting.
No, you are browbeating her. You know? And she doesn't even have the misfortune of working for you. Let me tell you something. If you are questioning her investigative skills, I'm here to tell you that she is going to be the next Woodward. So, what do you have up your bonnet?
It's nothing. Really, Lucinda was just, giving me some motherly advice.
About as motherly as Medea, I'm sure.
Actually, I have to head back to the trials.
No, I Isaac is gonna call and I might need you here to do some follow-up.
Okay, well, good luck with your call to Isaac.
Thank you.
And sweet cakes. We'll be talking from time to time.
Sweet. Hello, Jake here.
Jake, my man in New York came through.
What'd you find out?
There's a small blonde suffering from memory loss. She got picked up wandering the streets. They've got her at Bellevue now, pending definite ID.
It's her. I know it. It's Vicky.
Let's have chocolate milk with Hershey's syrup.
Dad, Hershey's is out. We switched to Church's chocolate Ovaltine.
Why?
Ovaltine's better for you. It has vitamins and minerals. Hershey's doesn't.
And it tastes great.
Mmm.
More Ovaltine, please.
Give a little love. A little squeeze and a little kiss. Give a little hug. I want some more of this. Take a little time.
Escape the demands. Experience the freedom. Leave the world behind.
Stetson Country Cologne for Men. Wear it and you're there.
Discover well-being in the Healing Garden, where soothing lavender therapies help relaxation grow. The Healing Garden. Holistic fragrances for the mind, body, and spirit.
Look what Daddy gets. Looks good, huh? You eat those peas. This is Daddy's.
When you make a Spamburger hamburger.
And all mine.
Watch out.
Perfect.
Because the premium pork and ham, spiced to perfection, makes Spam so good, it's gone. Spam, so good, it's gone.
Have a great idea? Expand on it. Introducing an all-new Kotex Light Days, the leading liner now with 20% extra coverage, so you're extra protected, extra comfortable. You've got it together with Kotex.
I just got a call from Mrs. Williams, Abigail's adoptive mother.
Yeah, like you need that.
Actually, she was pretty decent. But she made one thing very clear, that if I don't shape up, I will never, ever get the chance to meet my daughter.
You have family here?
Some.
So why aren't you staying at the Y?
You think I ran away from home.
Did you?
No. Maybe, in a way, I did.
Oh, parent stuff, huh?
Which set?
Oh, so it's a divorce thing?
Something like that.
How'd it go with Abigail?
Oh, actually, it went great. I didn't even screw up.
That's great.
Yeah, Mrs. Williams isn't my biggest fan still, but Abigail is perfect. And she's beautiful and charming and sweet and smart, and she's mine, Chris. I can't believe that I created something so wonderful. I'm sorry.
What's wrong? What is it? We can have fun later. We can spend more time together when you come
this
back.
This may be the last time that we ever see each other, Christopher.
You can't be serious.
My dad got a promotion, and we're moving to Saudi Arabia.
Saudi Arabia? No. No way. You can't do this right now. I mean, no way. So, how long is Abigail gonna be gone?
Too long.
When is she coming back?
Probably never.
I can relate to that.
Unless you've waited your whole life for someone, then you find them.
And they end up being way more amazing than you could have ever imagined.
Just to lose them again.
Just like that. You mean you're staying?
Woohoo! That's great! I thought I was going to have to go to Saudi Arabia and steal you back.
Are you going to tell me what's going on, or am I going to have to force it out of you?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about whoever's invaded your brain and obviously other parts of your anatomy.
When did you get so nosy?
I'm not nosy. I'm a woman, okay? And I happen to be curious.
Hey. No, stop.
Who is she, huh?
What are you
just
doing?
Just tell me who she is.
I'm not even ticklish.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, come on, Chris. We know each other a little better than that, don't we?
Molly.
Who is she? Just tell me.
Stop.
Well, it's not like I haven't seen it before. Who is she, Chris? I mean, do I know her?
Your guardians are going to be begging you to go out with
them. Oh, very funny.
I'm serious. I will do whatever they want. I'll follow all their rules. I'll have you go into G-rated movies. I'll have you in by 9 o'clock. I won't hold your hand without asking their permission. I'll do anything I can do to be able to see you.
I know. Okay. I read the notes.
I never wrote you any notes.
No? Well, what's this? Are you sleep writing? I love the sexy title, Tender as the Night. Come on, Chris. If I'm not the woman whose smile get you through the day, then who is?
All this time, Molly and Daisy, Abigail, talking about each other.
Okay, that should just about do it. Gay?
Oh, sorry. I was just noticing your house is so beautiful. No wonder Lily doesn't want to work. I wouldn't either if I can get to stay here all day.
Oh, don't let her hear you say that.
Why, did I say something wrong?
No, I just meant that, someday you'll know if you ever have kids. It's a lot of work raising kids.
Yeah, I know. I mean, she never had to work. I just try and imagine what that must be like. Yeah, when I was traveling on the road growing up with my mom, she was a club singer, well, lounge singer, actually. We never really stayed in one place very long. But this one year, we did get to stay in this town for like 3 months, and I actually had time to make a friend, Eliza. I never had a friend like that before, you know? She was confident, but kind. And, rich. Very rich. She lived in this amazingly beautiful house, but she wasn't stuck up for anything. She had this huge room with this canopy bed, these beautiful satin sheets, and comfy carpet, and this vanity table with silver brushes everywhere, and I used to sneak into her room, and I would... I guess what I'm saying is that her life seemed so much easier than mine.
I used to think that about Lily, that everything just came to her. You think I was born with a silver spoon in my mouth? Not really.
Really? I wouldn't have known that about you. I mean, you seem like you've always kind of lived this lifestyle.
No, I didn't, and... I can honestly tell you that money does not solve all your problems either.
That may be true, but if I could only solve all my money problems, I think I'd be happy with the ones that I have left.
What do you say we head back down to the station? See what Henry has cooked up for us today.
Yeah. Hello, I'm home. Beep.
Great.
Well. I'm gonna have to take the bull by the horns.
So they're gonna fax her picture?
Yeah, from Bellevue. It's got to be her. I mean, you don't know, Vicky. She can raise hell when she wants to. She's too smart. She's too smart to be caught by some zero IQ nobody. What she's done, she's outfoxed him, and she slipped away, and they just now caught her. You know, wait till I tell the kids. She'd see Vicky with those kids, and it's happening right before Christmas. Maybe, you know what? I should call and let the kids know.
Jake, maybe you shouldn't get your hopes up.
What are you talking about? The description, it fits her to a T. It's a petite blonde with blue eyes and a great smile. You know something? When I know that she's okay, I'm gonna fly to London, and I am gonna surprise those kids. Better yet, I'm gonna fly the kids here. I'll fly them to Bay City. You know what? I fly him to East Nowhere, Idaho. I don't care as long as we're together.
No, none of these are the sounds that I remember.
Describe it then.
It was quicker, it was faster, it was lighter, it was... Listen.
What?
Listen. What? That's the sound I remember that night. Listen.
So Jessica's shoes brought back the memory of the night Alec was shot? We've been making this way too hard. It's not something like shoes. It is shoes.
It is women's high heels.
Someone else was in the suite that night.
things that are good with honey, the best may be Honey Cough, the only line of cough drops and cough syrup that combine effective medicine with real honey. Honey Cough, a natural choice for coughs. From Robitussin.
Menopause affects you in more ways than one. That's why new Caltrate Plus Soy does more. It has soy isoflavones to help ease the effects of menopause and the calcium you need to help fight menopausal bone loss. New Caltrate Plus Soy, the Caltrate for menopause.
McDonald's is celebrating Disney and Pixar's Toy Story 2 with your favorite toys as candy dispensers. Collect all six. They do tricks.
Get the car.
Which way, Rex?
Right? I mean left!
Look out!
We're doomed!
Don't worry, we're here!
Where can you stuff your stockings with Toy Story 2 candy dispensers? Did somebody say McDonald's?
And one incredibly handsome Buzz Lightyear candy dispenser.
I'm getting mashed here!
All men's and women's winter sweaters are 30 to 50% off at Sears. Hurry in for the styles you want. Now that's something to get wrapped up in. Give the good life at a great price, guaranteed. Sears.
Want free greetings and great gifts for the holidays?
Just click me, baby.
Use your mouse to say more at egreetings.com. With the click of a button, you can send free, colorful, personalized greetings for every occasion. Plus, egreetings.com makes it easy to send thoughtful presents to everyone on your gift list.
You like them? I picked them out myself.
Say more, give more. egreetings.com.
Just click me, baby.
Best mistake I made in years.
How could I stay? How could I breathe? There had to be more for me. Promises gone, plastic and stone. I'm doing
show me where you hear the sound exactly
here,
right.
Anywhere that there's no
well, do
bug.
It for me. Do it.
Here and here.
You know what? This makes perfect sense. Whoever the woman was moving so fast, she was trying to cover her tracks. She was getting rid of the drug
here.
Wine, rinsing out the glass, and getting the bug that you planted and finding the drug vial.
Here. Oh, Tom. What if it was just the maid? What if it was just the maid who came in and saw that Alec and I were asleep?
No, it wasn't. Maids don't come in the room when people are snoozing, and they don't wear high heels.
Okay, I guess not, but... I was wearing heels. What if I'm just remembering my own walking?
No, because... No. You heard the footsteps when you were still in the bed, right? Somebody else was in the room. We find the woman, we find the murderer.